name is Violeta Martellini Edarda, and I'm from Greece. First of all, I would like to thank the ESPYT committee for the selection of this article, which is called Longitudinal Study of Spontaneous Gut Decolonization of Carbapenem-Resistant Gram-Negative Bacteria in Neonatal and Pediatric Patients. I would also like to thank all my colleagues for their collaboration and my professor, Professor Elidis, who was the supervisor of this project. As it's known, antibiotic exposure may convert gut microbiome to reservoir of resistant organisms, including carbapenem-resistant gram-negative bacteria. The aim was to evaluate the natural history of spontaneous carbapenem-resistant gram-negative bacterial decolonization of known agents in children and the risk to develop carbapenem-resistant gram-negative bacterial infection. It was a prospective cohort study of patients 1 to 86 years old, hospitalized in a tertiary care hospital, found to be colonized in weekly surveillance cultures during hospitalization between January 2018 and December 2019. Patients were followed after discharge with monthly rectal cultures of 12 months after colonization, and the colonization defined the three consecutive negative rectal cultures spaced at least 1 week apart. Patient demographics, clinical characteristics, and carbapenem-resistant gram-negative bacterial infection development were recorded. Polymerase chain reaction for carbapenemases was performed in patients colonized after 3 negative cultures at the day of the last negative and the day of the first new positive culture. So 130 patients included in the study, 53% were females. Median age was 1.3 per month, Klebsiella pneumonia predominated, 40% of the patients developed carbapenem-resistant gram-negative bacterial infection, mainly pneumonia and bloodstream infection. Minimum and maximum duration of colonization was 21 and 892 days respectively. Neonatal patients seem to decolonize earlier than pediatric patients, both all patients and no readmitted. Prolonged colonization, which defined test colonization for more than 6 months, duration of broad spectrum antibiotic use, and parenteral nutrition were factors associated with the development of carbapenem-resistant gram-negative bacterial infection. From PCR analysis, 2 patients were found to be positive after 3 consecutive negative rectal swab cultures, which is a percentage of 1.5% of the total patients. So in conclusion, neonates have a higher rate of decolonization than pediatric and adult patients from the literature. Approximately 1/3 of colonized children may develop carbapenem-resistant gram-negative bacterial infection. Prolonged colonization, lengthy duration of broad-spectrum antibiotic use and parenteral nutrition are factors associated with carbapenem-resistant gram-negative bacterial infection development. 3 consecutive negative cultures seems to be reliable enough to define decolonization. These findings are important since they may help to optimize duration of quantum precautions and the biological antimicrobial therapy for pediatric patients. Thank you very much.